I'm on my own, broken and alone. I feel the rain crashing down all around this empty town. I'm searching for the lost and found, but you don't care, you're unaware. Keep moving like the scars aren't even there. It's in the air like a blazing flare.
Hi, my name is Cheryl Bowden. I am one of the co-founders of the Lady Bass Anglers Association. This organization started in 2010, so we are 10 years old. We are not big, but we are made for ladies. We started when another organization stopped the women's tour. We all got together as a group of ladies on Kentucky Lake in 2010 and voted that we were going to run our own tour. And the ladies asked Secret York and I, who's the other founder, if we would take off and run it. And so we've done so. And this is our 10th year anniversary. We're a small family. We are not perfect, but it is an amazing way for ladies to get involved in fishing, to share the passion with other ladies, and to go out and have fun. We're as competitive as anybody else. Off the water, these ladies are friends. On the water, that's a totally different story. So what we'd love for you guys to do is just check us out. We've got our website, www.ladybassanglers.com. If you're on social media, we've got our Facebook page. You guys can go check that out. And we have a digital magazine for every tournament. And in that, you're going to get to see the different folks that support us, the cities, the sponsors. Click on their images and it'll take you to their website so you can check them out. And come out and watch us. You know, you're watching this video, so hopefully something about this is gonna pique your interest. If you're a lady out there who's going, I just don't know if I have the skill or not, we have at this event three ladies who have never fished a tournament in their life. They're nervous, yes, you're gonna be nervous. But if you ever wait until you think you're ready, you're missing out on an opportunity. The young lady who won our championship last year, in our wild card, she had fished every event and didn't make the championship by Angler of the Year points. But what we have for our wild card is any angler but one boater, one co-angler who fished the entire season but didn't make it in points, all their names go into a hat and they're drawn. She was the draw. She cried because she didn't feel like she was worthy. She didn't earn it. We get to the championship on Caddo Lake. She has a couple of mishaps just as a young boater. She wins the championship and has the highest classic total weight in history of the LBAA. Yes, it hurt me because that was my record for since 2012. That record held since 2012 when I had over 40 pounds for 3 days and she beat me. But I can't think of a better person to have done it than a rookie who thought she didn't belong, who was ready to go home, and realized she did have what it took. So you have what it takes, so come and join us.
Oh. official time is 5:29. 5:29. Ladies, have fun, be safe, take care of your fish. If they need to be fizzed, do it. So.
In the world. And she's from my hometown, by the way, so I claim her. Pam Martin Wells from Bainbridge, Georgia. Come on up, Pam. Woo! She has one more. And look at here, nice sack of bass, too. Looks like a limit. Is that right, Pammy?
Wow.
Wait, 14-17 for Pam Martin Wells. 14-17. Woo, baby. Yeah, three, and this is her first tournament ever. Y'all give her some love. First tournament, 7. Wait a minute here. It's a good first day. 760 for Lynette Fitz. one of those that's lucky enough to be retired in life. She's just fishing and having fun and taking it easy, enjoying herself. How many have we got, Robbie? Four bass for Robbie Hartline. The weight, 10-25. Good fish. Way to go, Robbie. If you had that one more. Up right here, she's U.S. Army. Great today. Look at here. Look at it. 12-91 for Gester. 12-91. Way to go, Linda. 12 limit today. Eagle Hawk from Indiana. The weight, 6-21. 6-21 for three fish. Way to go, Diana. 15-17 at the lead weight for the lead angler, and that's Pam Martin Wells. 14-17. Linda Gester is nipping at her heels. Linda's got 12-91. Robbie Hartline sitting in third with 10-25.
Hi, this is Lee Smith with Pro Gator Boats. We're here today with Lady Bass Anglers on Lake Pickwick, and we've had a great weekend and a great time with the ladies down here, and they absolutely crushed it. So congratulations to all the anglers on a great weekend and some great fishing. You know, at Pro Gator Boats, we wanted to let you know that we have what we consider to be one of the top of the line bass boats in the industry. It's been around for over 50 years. We're one of the original three manufacturers in the industry, and our boats are unparalleled, hand-laid fiberglass boats. We also back them up with our 10-year stump warranty, because every bass boat that we build comes with its own interior double hull. And what that means to you is that you have the hull under your boat, our stringer system, our flotation foam all throughout the bottom of the boat, and then an interior liner on top of that, that really provides unparalleled safety and ride and comfort in all of our bass boats. If you get an opportunity, come check one out. We'll try to have some at the upcoming events at the Lady Bass Anglers, and I guarantee you, you won't be disappointed. Thanks, guys.
Thank you.
fishing with us here on the LBAA. All right, way to go, Beth. Got one today. Good, looks like a pretty good fish. And we'll get it weighed up. And wait, Beth on the board, 449. Boy, that's a nice one, 449. Wish some love. Come on up, Robbie. Look at that sack of bass. We're about to set, it looks like we may set a Lady Bass Angler's record for a big sack. This is huge. Robbie, let's take a look here. Look here, folks. 1864. 1864 for Robbie Hartline.
And I kept looking down at my Garmin and I see all these fish swimming under the boat and I'm like, dang it, I'm gonna have to drop shot these fish. So I started drop shotting and I caught like three or four little ones. They were keepers, but all of a sudden then everybody wanted to eat. So then we started catching the big ones. So I mean, we had a great day together. Beth was wonderful to fish with, very helpful. I mean, she's pulling out Band-Aids for me and everything else. But great day. I caught them all pretty much on the red bug big worm. No Carolina rig, didn't throw it.
Robbie, congratulations on a wonderful day. Way to go. Come up here where you fish now. Pam Ridgel from Texas, she's got a couple of bass in the sack. And Ridgel has part of her family here, so we'll get her weighed up. And the weight, Pam, is going to be 370. 370. Wells in the lead on day one. Can she hold on to it? She's got a sack full today. Looks like five pretty good fish in there for Pam Martin Wells. The weight, 1172 for Pam Martin Wells. 1172.
But this has been an eventful week, okay? First, I lost a spook in about a 5-pound fish's mouth, and he had to jump 14 dozen times right there and say, "Nanny, nanny, boo, boo, I got your favorite spook." Okay. Yesterday, I thought we was gonna have to rescue somebody. I look, and not that I mind helping somebody, but I'm like, "Dang, I'm fishing the tournament. I ain't got time for this," you know. But there's a little John boat. There's about a 3-year-old little boy on the front, like this. Woman on this side and a man on this side, they got a hand on the boat and they swim. I'm like, "Hey, they trying to swim to a ramp?" So I pull over there, I said, "Y'all having trouble?" They said, "No, we're noodling." I'm thinking, you ain't gonna go noodling at Seminole. You might noodle something you don't want.
Back of her home lake in Sun South Georgia, by Seminole.
Then today, I'm sorry, Penny. Penny got home and I'm backing up to get her bait unhung. And I set the hook on my biggest fish. She runs up there to net my fish. We turn around, her rod's gone. So we try and try and try to get her rod. Well, we can't find it. And I told Penny, "I'm sorry. I told you if I won, I'd buy you a new rod. It looks like Robbie's got to buy you one." But anyway, we tried and tried to catch this dang rod and couldn't catch it. And then a few minutes later, she catches a spot. It hits the deck, goes in the splash well, off in the water. Well, she's down on her knees doing like this one, and she comes up with the fish. I'm like, "You lost a rod and you catch a dang fish that's gonna jump out of the boat back in the water." So it's been an eventful week, you know. Thank everybody. We've had a good time.
Thank you, Pam. Appreciate you, bud.
Congratulations, Robbie.
She's an Alabama fan. She's got, looks like a limit. Yeah, five bass. Way to go, Lisa. Oh, that's a pretty good sack, too. Way to go. Look at here, look at here, look at here. Oh, yeah! 17-8-4 for Johnson. Locking it out of the park, 17-8-4. Three bass for Eagle Hawk. Got her limit. The weight, 8-2-4. Way to go, Diana. 8-2-4. Come on up. Cassie Hall got a sack full. Looks like three bass got her limit today. Cassie Hall with three fish. The back of the boat today. The weight, 9-1-8 for Cassie Hall. 9-1-8. Way to go, Cassie. I've got a check here for the co-angler Tiny Bass. I didn't get a size, but it was real tiny. How big was it, Diana Ebelhock? How big was your tiny fish? Well, it won the prize. Come here and get your check. It was the smallest of the bunch, so there you go. Yes, indeed. Congratulations.
Thank you.
All right. Big bass on the coastside. Big bass on the coastside belongs to, in this nice check, to Rebecca Briley. Rebecca, where are you? Come here, Rebecca. Congratulations, that'll get you some gas back home.
Hang on. I ain't driving wrong
yet. Oh, you're not driving? Okay. Fourth place co-angler. This is a nice little check, too. Fourth place on the co-angler side, and I don't have the weight in front of me, sorry. Cassie Hall. Cassie, yeah. Congratulations. Hang on, Chris.
Hi, baby girl.
Okay, there you go. So a trophy and a can of check. There you go, sweet deal. There you go.
I was looking for you in the wrong place.
All right, on the third place, turn that left one. The left, the far left, turn down just a scotch. Yeah, there you go. Just a little bit more. There you go. Scoot right there. All right. Third place on the coast side. A nice check and a nice award to Rebecca Briley Jeffers. Come on, Rebecca. Two checks for her. How about that? Two checks and a trophy. Way to go, Rebecca. Second place on the coast side. Nice check. I think Daddy might already have this one spent for you. Kristen Baxter. Come on, Kristen. You want to slip this in your pocket, Mike? Way to go. Congratulations. Daddy's money. Is that a country song? I believe it is. But this is a nice, healthy check right here for the first place on the co-angler side, Diana Ebelhoff. What a sweet trophy and a sweet check. There you go. If you let her fish naked, is that what you said? Okay, fine. We'll get into that story another time and another place. Way to go, Diana. Congratulations. You want to say a few words to the crowd there? Please speak. Say your piece. There. Wait. Say it again.
I said, I love this game we play. Thank you, everybody that helped me get this. You know, I couldn't have done it without all of you that helped. So, thanks.
Congratulations, Diana. All right.
First thing, what's your name?
Diana Schmidt Eaglehawk.
All right, Miss Diana, how does it feel winning first place on the co-angler?
Oh my gosh, what a blessing this is. I mean, it's just awesome because now I qualify for the Classic too.
Are you looking forward to the Classic?
Very much so.
You think you're going to win that one?
I can only hope. I'm just going fishing like I did this time.
How many times have you fished on Lake Pickwick?
This is about the fourth time.
It's the fourth time, so you know the lake pretty well.
No,
still
it's
no.
It's different all the time because of how who you go out with. So.
Right. How was practice compared to tournament days?
Practice was slow. I had one good day of practice, and my husband and I came down here early, and we got to fish a day and a half together. So yeah, it was good. I mean, I always come and fish with two of the ladies that. Or both, so it was good practice.
What was your secret into catching your big fish today, getting your big limit?
Today was really different because I did not take my crankbait rod, and that's what my boater is catching all of her fish on. And I had to come up with something to adjust to be able to catch fish with her because we did it all day long. We just catching fish. And I decided I was just gonna try throwing a Texas rig and ripping it through the grass. So That's what got it for me.
Way to go, way to
walk. I got to call twice, three times. So, yeah, it was a good day.
Well, congratulations on your win.
Thank you.
Woo! All right, now we're going to move to the pro side. The tiny bass on the pro side. The tiny bass. A nice chick to buy a carbon copy for tiny bass. Tiffany Hart. Tiffany, bring one up here. Tiff, congratulations on your tiny bass award. There you go. Congratulations. All right. Well, I suspect she's going to get another check besides this, but we got a pretty healthy little check here for the pro big bass, and that goes to Robbie Hartline. That's super giant. She's the big bass. Big bass. Yeah. Way to go, Robbie. Congratulations. Yeah. Fourth place. This is a pretty healthy check right here, too. Fourth place. And we're going to call up Lisa Johnson. Come on, Lisa. And she's got a trophy and a check here. You buy Mike a new cigar. I know you will. Congratulations. Mike wants a loaf of bread. All right. Third place on the pro side. Healthy check. Nice trophy going to Linda Gessner. Come on, Linda. Way to go, Linda. Congratulations. All right. Well, it looked like after day one she might just roll with it, but it didn't happen, did it? She came in second, though, got a nice check and a nice trophy for second place, Pam Martin Wells. Pam, come on up here. She had some good competition up here in the top of this, come on up here. It doesn't matter either way, whichever side. You can jump if you'd like, do this high jump right here. That would work. As much as you run, you could probably high jump that. Go ahead and get your picture made over there. Way to go, Pam. Thank you. Appreciate it.
All right, so we're here with the legendary Pam Martin Wells, one of the best female bass anglers, from what I've heard, the world. So, Miss Pam, how was your day on the lake today?
Yeah, I had a good day. Caught a lot of fish, caught a lot of non-keepers. So, I mean, it makes for, you know, a fun day when you're catching fish, whether they keep or not. I mean, today I just couldn't catch a kicker fish like I did yesterday, and I knew before I ever come in I needed another, you know, 4 or 5 pound fish, and I just couldn't make it happen. I had a solid limit that weighed right at 12 pounds, so, you know, you can't complain with that. And I'm not taking nothing away from Robbie, but a lot of times a big fish is luck, you know, and I just couldn't put one in the boat today. But we had a good day. We made a really long run, like I say, and caught a ton of fish, so. So it was a fun day.
Man, on day one, you almost had everyone scared. Coming in with 14.7 pound bag, that was the biggest of the day. So yeah. We really thought you were going to come in today with another big one.
Yeah, like I say, you know, I had almost a 5 pound kicker yesterday, and I tried everything in the world, and I just couldn't get a bigger fish today. I don't know, as a whole, it seemed like they all shrank, because yesterday I didn't catch as many non-keepers as I caught today. So, you know, I don't know. Weather, something changed, moved them or something, and I just couldn't get on a good bite. But like I say, you know, as long as you can be consistent, that's about all you can ask for. And you know, I was fairly consistent, 14-12 pounds, so you know, I'm pleased. I would have loved to have won, but hats off to Robbie, she did a fantastic job.
Now, what was one of your favorite baits you were using out there on the tournament days?
Man, I used a bunch, but
what produced the most catches then?
I was using a shaky head with a Magnum finesse worm. What did most of it. I caught some on top water, which is always fun, but the shaky head was predominantly the bait.
How was practice compared to tournament days? Did you have better luck in practice or better luck during the tournament?
Actually, it was better in the tournament, but having said that, I spent a lot of time in practice trying to find fish deep on ledges and stuff, and it just wasn't happening. I actually found the spot that I fished in the tournament during practice. So, you know, that's kind of a catch-22 question. My practice wasn't that good, but I was looking for stuff that wasn't happening, if that makes sense. Yeah. I mean, I knew if we could get on that one or two big schools of fish, and I just couldn't find them. And obviously, they're not out there yet.
Mm-hmm. Well, did you get rained on today with all the weather we were having?
I did get rained on today. I did not yesterday. I know they said it flooded up here, and it was just like a foggy mist on us yesterday. Now, we did get rained on today, but even then it wasn't that bad. I never even put my rain suit on, so it wasn't that bad. But, you know, what I was doing, I really needed the sun to position the fish correctly in the cover, and just didn't have it. So, but that's fishing. You got to adjust. And, I mean, I did adjust to catch the ones I caught, but not enough.
All right, now tell me about this college bass angling that you're doing. Where's that at?
I'm now the head coach for Emmanuel College. That's in Northeast Georgia. It's 35 miles southeast of Athens, where the University of Georgia is. It's a private Christian college. This year was our first year having a team. And thanks to COVID, we actually never got to compete. I've done a lot of recruiting. We've got a really good team coming up this year for next year. We've got 26 anglers, six or seven or eight of them just went to the national finals for the high school and for FLW. So, you know, we've really put together a great team, and I look forward to next year. And, you know, to me, I've been very fortunate. The good Lord's blessed me in my career and all the fishing that I've done, and if I can give back just a little bit to that, you know, for some of these young folks, that'll make it all worthwhile. And we're looking forward to it, and it's kind of a dream job. You know, I get to go fishing and
teach the new generation how it's done.
That's right.
All right, well, the legendary Pam Martin Wills, everybody, thank you so much.
Thank you.
Well, we got to put her on the microphone. She's going to tell you all the secrets she knows, and she's got a nice, big, healthy check and a nice, beautiful trophy. Your winner on the pro side, Robbie Hartline. Robbie, congratulations. Get your trophy here from Mikey, and please say a few words over there on the mic after you get your picture made. Way to go, Robbie. The mic is yours.
Thank you all for coming out and participating with us on this tour. I love doing this. This is, you know, I'm retired now. Frankly, I think this kind of keeps you younger because you get up and you go do something. You got some challenge to be tackling. So I talked a lot about what I did on the water. I want to say one thing for sure. I was blessed today. I was blessed yesterday. There was no way that what I figured out in practice was going to translate into a win. It just so happened that we happened to stop on this one ledge yesterday that was holding really nice fish, and it was my objective to get back there today. And when I went there, there was somebody on it, but the gentleman was sweet, and he let me have it. And I don't know if we would have caught much if I hadn't been able to get back on that ledge. So, you know, I love
Good dry out somewhere, Robbie.
Let's just go with the flow. Okay, first off, give me your name.
Robbie Hartline.
How long have you been with the LBAA?
Since the beginning. I've never missed a tournament yet.
So you've been with them since 2010?
Yes.
Okay, how many times have you fished Lake Pickwick?
This is my second time.
Second time?
Mm-hmm.
Has it gotten easier?
Well, last time I did okay, but no, I don't know that it got easier. It's just, It's like Kentucky Lake to me. I love ledge fishing, and that's what I do.
How did you do last time you fished on Lake Pickwick?
I think I was somewhere in the middle of the pack.
Middle of the pack?
Yeah.
And compared to this time, where you're pretty much leading the pack, how does that feel?
I feel great today, yeah.
What was your bag on the first day? What was it, like 12?
I only had 4 fish on the first day, and the weight was a little over 10 pounds.
A little over 10 pounds. And today you came in with a whopping 18 point... What was it again?
I don't know the exact...
18.5, 18.6?
Something like that,
definitely,
yeah.
The biggest bag of the day.
Right.
That must feel pretty good, huh?
Yes. Awesome.
Awesome, awesome.
The overused word. But, no, there was a time today that after I caught the big fish, that I just had to sit down on the deck for a minute because I couldn't believe it myself, and I was shaking, and you know. But you never really know what's going to happen on any given day. And today it started off kind of slow, and I was really worried about just catching a fish. And we finally got back on a spot that where I caught fish yesterday. Sorry, I got a bug in my eye. But we went there this morning, and somebody was sitting on it. And I didn't even approach it then. We went other places for about an hour and a half or so. And I really wanted to get on that spot, so I went back over there, and he was still there. But he put his trolling motor up, and he came by to talk to us. He was in an aluminum Ranger. And he said that he was having a hard time holding the line on the fish with his aluminum boat. So he said, go ahead and fish it. And I thanked him, and we did. And that's how we caught all of our fish off of that one particular ledge. There was a big school there. When we first started fishing it, it was slower today than yesterday. And I think the difference was I saw fish on my Garmin underneath the boat, and I wasn't getting bit on the big worm, so I put the big worm down and I started drop shotting those littler fish. And I boated a couple, 3 15 inchers, and then the other fish got fired up, and then we started catching.
Now, what were you putting on that drop shot again?
I was throwing a robo worm.
A robo worm? Robo worm. What color? Yeah.
Morning Dawn.
Morning Dawn. Did the rain affect you at all today? Did you get rain on or anything?
No, we didn't get rained on. I was fishing down close to Waterloo, and we didn't really have rain today or yesterday. So we had wind yesterday. I thought it was going to be windy today, but it wasn't bad at all. It missed it a little bit, but not enough to even put my rain gear top on. I just had the pants on.
Yeah, just stay a little dry.
Stay dry all day.
Well, I think that's it. Robbie Hartline, our Lake Pickwick winner for the year.
Thank you.
Way to go, Miss Robbie.
Thank you.
I'm on my own, broken and alone. I feel the rain crashing down. All around this empty town, I'm searching for the lost and found. But you don't care, you're unaware. Keep moving like the scars aren't even there. It's in the air, like a...